Welcome to our electrical research channel. In this video, I will explain you about how to draw the circuit waveforms in Visio. By using Visio software, we can draw effectively the circuit diagrams for effective presentation in the paper and research paper. By our own, we can draw some circuits and we can edit our waveforms, our results. From MATLAB or some other softwares, whatever we are getting the output waveforms, we can edit through the Visio software also. The Visio software is freely available in internet. You can download it. I am using currently in 2007 version. Mine is licensed version. So you can open Visio. It is also Microsoft Office product. You can easily convert these diagrams to MS Office or PDF or any other formats. By default, it will ask the basic electrical or data flow diagram, or many applications are there. You can also go to here. You can start either business or these are the formats. General formats in engineering, basic electrical is there, and basic electrical in US, it is metric. Many formats are there. You can see the flow charts and all these things. But generally, I am basically from electrical engineering. I selected this electrical engineering. So by default, it is showing 40%. So this is the 100%. So whatever this is the page is there, it is for A4 sheet. And dimensions we can see here. When we are draw the waveform, we can see the dimensions. And generally, this is the MS Office document. Generally for IEEE format, I am talking about the only IEEE formats. It is double column. IEEE is the double column format. The paper is like A4. By default, I am selecting all these things by default. Generally I will keep it this symbol because I want to see the format and spaces and everything. So if you are clicking this thing, it will gone, but with this one we can do the effectively. The format is like, initially it is single column, and after that it's a double column. The difference is there. This is the single column and this is the double column. And if you want to see whether it is double column or not, you can see like this. This is one column and this is another column. But this is only one column is there. If you are clicking this thing, then you don't know whether it is which format it is there. So don't confuse it. This is the only symbol which I am using to identify the format and spaces and everything. So I will make it Times New Roman, and this is 10. Here it is basically 25. If it is 2pi, then it is nearly 3.25. This space is 3.25. 3.25 is nearly 85 to 90 mm. I'm talking about in mm. It is in inches, but I'm talking about in mm. Because I want to insert diagram in this area, in single column area, and sometime I want to insert diagram in single column area also. In double column, the dimension I will draw at 90 width. Width is the 90 and height is depends on our diagram. 90 is mm, not in centimeters or not in inches. It is mm, 90 mm. For effective visualization, I will draw all the circuits by keeping at 400%. Here you can see a simple control logic I will draw. you can see the all I mean the blocks are there, so you can easily identify how much diagram you want to draw. See, if you want to like this, then you can draw. And this is the line width, line weight. See, this I selected generally this format, and you can select the more weight over here. And see, I want to draw the cross symbol here, so I will select the line. And simple thing, I will draw like this, and I will make it is group. Group means, see, either you can select like group, or you can press the Control G. Control G also group. So again I will click here, then by default it will be 2. See, this I will insert to here. See, again I will make it the group. Then whenever I am moving, the complete things will move. So see, the thing is, you have to manage your diagrams by checking carefully with these blocks. See, the width and height and everything will be the uniform. So I will make, see, this is the middle point. This line is the middle one. So I will draw the line over here only. See, and I want the arrows like this. See, this one is the arrow, but I want very small arrow. I mean the end point is very small. See, I will, by default I will select the both these things. See, this is the very small. So if I will make it is at 100%, then I will see how it is looking like. See, this much is okay for me. So I will manage all dimensions like this. See, simple thing, I will write VDC. So by default I will take 8 PT. 8 PT is the correct format for font size for IEEE format. See, and this VDC, and this is like this, and I will make, see, this one, this is the VDC. If you want VDC store or like that, you can also go for equations. See, from objective you can go for equation. See, if you want to do like this, then you can do it DC store. Generally for reference values we are considering like this. In equation also you can make it width and height and everything, the font size or this font and font size and either bold or anything, everything you can make it in the equation. That is a different thing. See, simple thing I want to make it. See, so generally I will make it. See, this line will be overlapping with this arrow. See, that is blind thing. For me it is the perfect overlapping. See, if it is plus and minus, then I won't write it plus and minus. I will make it like plus and minus. So see, if you want to smaller than this, you can do it like this. So by left and right arrows you can do it. If you want to like minus, then simple thing, So now this dimensions 2 will be matching. See, whatever the minus is there, the same dimensions positive will be there. So after that again PA controller will come. So for PA either you can draw like this or you can draw individual. After then you can make it group. Anything you can make it. See, if you want to remove the, I mean, it is white color, it is coming and it is dotted is coming. I mean, transparent is there. So if you want to remove, you can make it fill no color like this. So both will be the same. And I will make it here, and I will write PI controller. So by default it will be like Arial and 6, but I will make it like Times New Roman and 8. 8 font is the perfect one. Already I told you. So see. So whatever PI is there, above one I will take. I mean one block, and here above one block, and it is also above one block. Like see. So again I will make it group, then it is group. See, so you have to write all, you have to design all these blocks. And see, this is simple controller, and after that pulses or whatever may be. I don't want to explain everything about this controller, because I want to explain you how to draw the circuit diagrams or how to draw the control diagrams or whatever in the Visual software only. See, if you draw the PV, then see, I will take this much line, and this two lines, I mean one two lines I will take. Then two lines I will drop in this end, and this is simple PV. So 1 to 1, see it is 1, and this length is also 1. I mean space is unique. This space is unique now. It is now PV. I mean, generally we are drawing like this. This is the PV, but you can also copy the diagrams or images from Google or whatever. Maybe you can paste it here or you can insert here. You can use those diagrams also, but you can edit those things. So see, now if you want to change like this, you can do it. So maybe this is PV. Let us assume. And one more controller is also there. Let's do. Let us assume. See. Again, I will come to 100%, and I will make it complete G. See, if this is one diagram, then you can see the width is 89, height is 13. If you want to more height, then you can do it the height. See, this is the height. So it is 50 now. This is the width. If width is like 85 to 90, then it will be paste perfectly in double column format. See. Now I copied the diagram there and I pasted here. See, it is perfectly it is coming. If you remove like this, it will show like this. See, if your diagram is more than this one, I mean, see, I want like this. Now the width is 150. It will paste here. It will paste here. It's not a problem. It will automatically adjusted in this area. But see, the resolution is very poor. Compared to this, the resolution is very poor. See how much VDC is here, how much VDC is here, how much PA controller, how much PA controller, how much VDC, how much VDC. But here the VDC is the same one. Even though I drag it here, the VDC is same thing, because see, I am maintaining only 8. See, all are 8, but still here it is not showing, because 150 width, 150 width, here I am adjusting into the 90 width, in the space of 90 width, so it is not properly coming. So if this 90 width, if you want to do it, the 150 width, so you do one thing as your one, if that much diagram is there, let us assume if that much diagram is there, then you can go for single column. See, single column, again I paste it. See here VDC, this is also 150 width, this is the VDC, this is the VDC, so the resolution will be more compared to readjusting the diagrams. See, so the only the thing is how you are inserting the diagrams and how much width you are maintaining. So before drawing the circuit, you have to maintain your width properly at maybe from 85 to 90 for IEEE. Like in elsewhere, you can maintain like 140 to 150. That is the standard one. 140 to 150 width is the standard one. IT depends on your circuit. See, if you are having one MATLAB model and we are running it, see, I am running this model. It is simple thing, simple model. One source is there and measurement is there, load, RL load is there, and nonlinear load. Nonlinear load I want to present for the harmonics. See how we can insert the FFT analysis. See, the scope is there, and these are nonlinear voltages. I mean voltage due to nonlinear, and I am saving this as a V. So this is as a V with structure with the time. So the problem is some time. How much time I am running? See, 10 seconds. It is 10 seconds running. So this is the V. This is the V. But see, the values are coming up to 50,000 points, or I mean not 50,000, like 5 lakhs points. See, I will plot. So up to 5 seconds. If you are thinking that this is the seconds, actually this is with sample time actually. If you are thinking that this is the time, then this is coming up to 5 seconds, not for 10 seconds. So you should not do like this. You have to do, V. Actually in V signal, one time is there, another one is signal is there. But time is coming to up to 5 lakh points, not 10 lakh. I mean, because I selected sample time as 2 e to the power of minus 5. So it is taking like, see, 0, 2 e to the power of minus 5, 4 e to the power of minus, like sample time. So your time is 10 seconds, but your samples are 5 lakh only. So by default, the samples will show, in diagram samples will show. So to avoid this one, see how I am doing. To avoid this one, plot x-axis and y-axis. This is actually v dot time. V dot time, and this is V dot signal, and V dot signal and values, but it is V dot time. So I am plotting x axis is V dot time, and y axis is v dot signals and values. See, the same diagram I am getting up to 10 seconds. So now x axis is 10 seconds. You can do it over here, or you can do it, you can edit the x axis in Visio itself. You no need to worry about x axis and y axis. See, so it is the sinusoidal and 50 Hz. So many sinusoidals are there. I can't see it. I want to see only from 5 seconds to like up to 2 cycles or 3 cycles only. Like I want to see like this. I want to present my results are like that. So your x-axis may be time. You can write time over here. If you are forget, then you can edit in Visio itself. So I will write only time. I don't write about the y-axis, and in y-axis I will edit in the Visio itself. See, so this is 5 seconds and this is 5.2 seconds, means 10 cycles. See, this is the 10 cycles, but 10 cycles are very high number of cycles in 50 Hz. So I want to see only 5 cycles. So 5 cycles means, see, this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cycles, or 4 cycles you can do, or 5 cycles you can do, whatever may be. And if you want to do edit the y axis voltages and currents like 310, you can do it for good visualization. This is for good visualization purpose. So if I want to present these results, then make it save. You do one thing, you have to save it in two formats. One is in .fig, matlab.fig voltage. If I will save it like .fig, I can edit this in any time. See, if later on if I want to edit, and if I want to change the y-axis properties and x-axis properties, you have to open again the model and you have to run it again. But it is not required. If once you have saved it .fig, you can edit any time. See the voltage is there. This block you can edit. For Visio, again you have to make it save as in .emf file, enhanced meta file. So this enhanced meta file, you can't edit it from MATLAB. See, this is the enhanced meta file. And this will open in like pane, like, see. And this I can't change it anything. So basically this thing I can change it, I can edit from Visio. I will show you how to edit it, but before that I will remove, but anyway it may be overlapping, it is not a problem. So go to insert and picture, and from file see voltage map. But see, this will come the complete diagram. See this much diagram is coming. So before editing I will make it ungroup, and I will remove this one. See, now only circuit is there. So before editing again I will do it group. If you are not making the group, then the formats will be changed. See, once it is the group, I will make it time New Roman, and this is 8 PT. And if it is double column format, like I want 90 maximum, so I will make it 85, because again I have to add something in y-axis, so 85. And generally this will be 45 for good visualization in for IEEE format. This is 85, so again I will make it at 400. So see, because the maximum resolution will give the, I mean maximum zoom will give the good resolution while editing. Again I will make it ungroup, and see, this is the 300 volts, these are 200 volts. If you want to change any value like 300 to 30 also you can do it here. So see, some manipulations also can be done, but I won't encourage those manipulations. So from MATLAB itself you can get it the very good results, because if you are doing some manipulations, the reviewers can easily identify. So this is the time axis. You can change it, location. So actually this is the middle point, so this is also the middle one. I am moving like this. If you press the shift button, then slowly it will move. I mean, 1/10th part of the movement will be done for one click. So this is the time. Now it is coming like this. So I will move downwards or upwards. So this is the actual time period. But the final one I will draw like this. I don't want to encourage like this one, because the dimensions will stop from here. I mean the width will be stopped from here. I want to stop the width from here itself. So I will do like this. So once I done all these things, I will select. The selection will be taken from press the control and you can click over all these things. So control G, it is group. So easily I can move. I mean without doing, if individually I am doing, one thing will become upwards and one thing will become downwards like that. So these things are, you can easily select all these things. See, without the group also, once it is selected, I can move it. And now I will write, this is the voltage. Voltage V. Or phase voltage, or whatever the names, you can add it. See, it won't go like this. Beyond like this, see, one block is left between this voltage and values. And see, your waveform should be highlighted, then your grid, this is the grid. So you have to select all these grids. See, I am selecting few grids, not all, but you have to select all grids. And you have to make it width as a line 1. So see, whatever I selected, the width is less, and not selected, width is more. See, but you have to select all these things. Keep it in mind that you have to select all this. Again, I will come to 100, and again I will make it group. Then I will see whether it is width is coming. If it is more than 90, I will adjust to 90. See, if it is 40, more than 45, but then I am adjusting. If you are adjusting this one, like see, maybe 60, then maybe lines will see, the values will go like this. Again, we have to readjust this one. So before copying, you have to do everything. So again, 100%. If you want to write any arrows, or if you want to do identification of this one, this kind of arrows will be done. This kind of arrows will be done. Like VA, I can write here VA, or VB, or VC, whatever. This is the one thing. Or if you want to do the lines, see, you no need to go. Sorry, you no need to go the coloring. From here itself, I will copy this waveform, and by doing this thing, automatically it will come to the line. So this is A phase. Let us assume this is the A phase. So I will write VA. So this is VA. I will make a group. I will bring to here somewhere. If it is space is there, somewhere we have to keep it here like this. The groups. See, this is the waveform, this is the circuit I am doing, but generally I will consider these things. See, for better visualization. See, I will fill with this pin and I will send it to the back. Then my waveform, I mean my circuit will appear. So if you want to make it this complete grid edge like dotted, then you can do it the dotted itself. Or if you want to make it any one edge dotted, then you can do it the dotted. So again I will make it this group, and generally I will paste it this way, this diagrams with the border and with colorful diagrams. I will make it and I will paste it over here. See, the difference is there. Generally, see, the difference is there. The appearance is that only the appearance is the different thing. And this waveform I will bring it to here. See, it is coming over here. By double clicking here itself, you can edit if video is there. So this is the thing. You can do it, the waveforms and all these things. But in case of FFT analysis, see, I will bring FFT analysis. I selected voltage, I selected start time at 5, and number of cycles is 1. And my fundamental frequency is 50 and maximum frequency is 1000. And this is bar chart I want. See, this is actually this is my fundamental and this is my THD. See, if you are considering 3 cycles, then also your THD is same. But it is thing, if you are considering 10,000 frequency, then it will looks like. So it is based on actually appearance and how you are doing. I mean how you want to present it. So 10,000 frequency is there. So it is very high actually. Even though 1000 is also very high, the frequency is very high. See, once you are doing like this, you have to. Sorry. You have to remove this one completely. You have to remove completely this one. And see, I deleted this one. See, if you are changing the frequency, the value won't be changed because the THD is the same one. It will automatically calculate all the frequencies, all the odd harmonics. But the display is how much you want to display. I mean up to 1000 or up to 10,000 or up to 5000, that is the thing only. So by changing your appearance, your values won't be changed. So now this is the only thing. So now I will save as in EMF in my project 14 FFT analysis. Now I will bring this FFT analysis. See, I will remove this one But here fundamental frequency line is very, very, very high. See, the fundamental frequency is very, very, very high. Height is 1121 mm. You can do it anything. See, you can change anything from here. So again, you have to copy the nearest one. I will remove this one. So again group. If it is fundamental, let us assume it is fundamental. I will make it 4000, then it will be good. If it is fundamental, just it have to be like more than this height, because fundamental is the very, very, very much high, like 275, but this is coming up to 5. So now this is the fundamental. Let us assume if the place is, if it is near, like, let us assume if place is near. So after that, if you want to remove this one, then you can remove. See, if you want to remove this one, you can remove. If you don't want to remove that the border, you no need to remove it. It is actually depends on your choice. So if you don't want to remove, see, then it will be appear. So again, I will make it group, and I will do it times New Roman, then 8pt. And this is now 90, because x axis and y axis everything is there. This is maybe now 40. See, this is now my FFT. If you want to change this edge in single line, see, the single line you can make it whatever. I already told how to do this properly. X-axis, so this one. So see, if you want to change the color and everything, then you can do it, no problem. This is the line color, this is the filling color, and this is the font color, the names. So once it is coming to again, sorry, it is not in group. Now it is group. Copy. See, this is the effective analysis. So like this, I will edit the in Visual. So see, many softwares are there for editing. Professional softwares also there. But this is the basic thing. This is very, very much useful to learning scholars, and you can make it the resistance, and you can make it the inductance, and all these things over here, and you can draw any circuit from these things, and you can even though insert many diagrams, so you can make it width and height and everything. See, if in your system it is showing in inches, then you have to do some changes in your settings. That's enough, because MS Office, MS Word or MS Office all are this video and all these things will be designed by Microsoft, and your OS is also designed by Microsoft. So the settings may be in default, maybe it is in inches or maybe it is in meters or whatever, but my settings are in mm. So I done it mm. If it is not showing, then you have to go for the view and in resize the position window, but then automatically it will show you. See, if I will make it one diagram, I will do it like this. If I will make it another diagram, and I will make it like this, because see, this is also A4. I want to see how much distance and how much gap is there, and what is the width of these two, and what is the visibility of these two. I will make it for 100, and I can check it this thing. So you can draw the beautiful diagrams for your writing the paper, research paper, because the research papers will allow you to draw the circuits over like this, not in any Word document or not in any paint, or you can't paste it your direct waveforms from whatever the MATLAB or other software like PSpice or anything from there to here. So it will be very much helpful, basically the Visio software. So I hope you enjoyed a lot. Thank you very much for watching our channel and our videos. Please subscribe our channel, and the WhatsApp link is available in description. You can join in our WhatsApp group itself to know more about the research videos. Thank you very much.